106.1 Kiss FM, all the hits. I'm Gavin. I'm joined in studio now by the largest number of guests I've ever had in here, and that is most of the cast, I feel like, from the upcoming production of a Rocky Horror Picture Show taking place this weekend. I've got Tony Shepherd-John here, the director. I've got Weston, who's one of the Phantoms. I've got Kanan, who's Riff Raff. I've got Jared, who's part of the live band Nine from Outer Space. I've got Preston, who plays Frankenfurter. I've got China from our sister station, and also my friend. And yeah.
No, we're acquaintances at best. I've told you that many times.
That is fair. We are all sharing microphones. It's very intimate in here. Now, Tony, tell me a little bit about who's putting this on and how you got involved.
Oh, how I got involved. Okay, Stage 2 Productions is putting this on. How I got involved is I'm a member of the board, and Sydney Shripka, who is my co-director for this production, asked me to co-direct with her last year, and this is an annual event for us.
Okay, very cool. And then next to you, we've got Preston, who is the man.
Hello.
You are the Frankenfurter.
Yes, sir.
Now, I've heard a rumor. I've heard a rumor that anybody who's asked if they would make out with you, the answer is always yes.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes. Now, how excited are you to be portraying an iconic character that was first done by Tim Curry?
Oh, I'm very honored. The pleasure's all mine. Life is a party.
I've seen some of the behind-the-scenes stuff, and it, like, your dancing is phenomenal.
Thank you.
I'm very excited to just be drawn into everything that you're doing.
Oh, we'll put on quite a show for you, Gavin.
No, just for me?
Absolutely.
Oh, fantastic. One thing that's very cool about it is there's going to be an actual live band who is led by Jared.
That is correct. So, me and Tony were working on some stuff for Timmy of the Shrew with Evansville Shakespeare Players, and we started talking about the idea of having a live band, and it's actually the first time that they've done it with a live band, and I was tasked with wrangling up a bunch of ragtag musicians and learning the score and getting it all ready, and it's been a lot of fun so far. It's been very challenging. Richard O'Brien, who played Riff Raff in the film from, I think, 1975, actually composed
The
original score for the play. And to me, it's just been really cool merging the worlds of local Evansville music and local Evansville theater, because there's so many talented people here. It's nice for everyone to have a chance to work together like that.
Yeah, and
bands also in costume and embracing every single moment of it. So if you want to see Jason Vincent in a blonde wig and a dress.
Oh, more than anything. Totally more than anything.
Yeah, and it adds a really an extra layer of energy.
That's awesome. Now I'm going to turn things over to Kanan here, who's playing Riff Raff.
Hello.
Yes, I love it. Now, how do you approach a character like Riff Raff? Like, what do you do to get into character?
It's just astounding, I tell you. It begins with just a hump on the shoulder and a long, stringy wig.
And that's all there is to it? And that's all there is?
Well, I also have no eyebrows, and that also, that brings a little extra kick to the role, I must say.
Well, I'm glad that your scoliosis has, like, cleared up for today's interview and that you didn't...
My drag name is Alopecia. I apologize to whoever is offended by that.
Which is probably, it's Evansville, so probably everybody. It's going
so
to be everybody.
I'm so sorry.
All right, now, Weston, you're one of the Phantoms, and you're kind of like one of the backbones of the entire production, right?
Yes, we help create the scenes. We are the car, we're part of the castle, and then we do all the choreography. We mess with the audience, so if you don't want to be messed with, don't come to the show, because more than likely, you're going to be touched.
You can come to the show. Just sit higher up.
Yeah. You're like, no, don't tell people not to come to the show. No, you should come to the show.
If you want to be not touched.
And there's kind of not almost, I think there's two scenes that Phantoms aren't in the entire show. They are literally in everything in the show. Yeah.
Now, you kind of touched on the crowd interaction of this. So I'm going to ask China, like, how are people like interacting with the show? Like, is it like the Rocky Horror viewings when people can like yell stuff and throw stuff or...
Yes, very much so. First of all, Tony, we're probably going to mention that the things that you can throw, do not bring your own things. We will be providing the things for you to throw. The things for you to shout, you can bring those. You can just shout them all throughout the show. This is just like going to the movie, shouting all the things that you need to shout. We actually practice with people shouting certain things so that we can get prepared for it and it won't like throw us off. And it's really awesome.
So Magenta, you're saying no bags.
No bags.
Okay.
Bring all your sass, though. We like sass.
Bring all the sass, all the bags that you can possibly handle.
No.
No bags.
No. I said no bags, didn't I?
said bring bags.
Did I say bring bags? Bring bags of sass. Sass. Yes.
Sassy bags.
Sassy bags. There we go. Now, how can people check out this great time, Tony?
There is an event on Facebook for Stage 2, or like Stage 2 Productions on Facebook. You can email me directly or Stage 2 Productions for tickets, and we will hold them at the door. We will release tickets 15 minutes before the show, so be there early. We also will have a bar that's open 45 minutes before the show with local beer and wine for you to partake in. Yes. And
which means the midnight show is going to be fun.
Will be fun, yes. Yes, it'll be a good time.
All right, well, I will have all the details on our website at 1061evansville.com. To the entire cast of Rocky Horror Picture Show, thank you so much for stopping by today.
Thank you,
Gavin.
Thank you.